It's not often that something brand new comes along and creates a new category. That's a very rare moment in time. So it's very easy when something new launches that naysayers come out of the woodwork and all beat it down and say why it's not going to work. And it's so gratifying to see that instead it's one of the greatest things we've ever done. No one predicted in their highest estimates it would be as successful as it has been. The iPad, according to some industry experts, is the fastest growing new product in history.
You know, in 10 years of retail, I've never seen anything like the launch of the iPad. You know, I just remember that first day, and it wasn't how many we sold, which was an all-time record. It was the number of people that want to put their hands on this product. The number one reason people come to our stores is to try a product that they've heard about but never experienced firsthand. And the iPad is a product that has to be held, has to be touched, to truly understand how magical it is.
The iPad is not a personal computer. It's beyond that. Some people call it a post-PC device because it can do some of the things the PC did in a far more personal way. The iPad has become a global phenomenon. It's universal in the sense that it appeals to a wide range of people, from small children all the way up to senior citizens. And it's true worldwide. And then on top of that, it's finding new uses in places that we never imagined.
The Chicago Public Schools is the third largest school system in the country. It is difficult to keep kids motivated in school and keep them engaged in the curriculum and materials. What we're seeing with the iPad is that they are engaged. You put the iPad in front of them and you'll see the kids immediately focus right on that content and start working through it. In a short amount of time, we're seeing gains as high as 50 to 60% in reading, math, and science with our classrooms using the iPads. I really believe that this is the future of education.
Sometimes doctors are overwhelmed with data. What we've tried to do on the iPad is to give doctors at the point of care the tools they need at the exact moment the doctor can make a difference. What we're finding with the iPad is that doctors are spending more time with patients. In fact, doctors are engaging patients by showing them images, showing them data on the screen. So it's empowered doctors to be more productive, but it's also brought doctors and patients together. So I think what's so exciting about the iPad is it will change the way doctors practice medicine.
The power of the iPad is it becomes a window into everything that's important to me in running my business. I've got our corporate communication on here. I have our data management system on here. Our customer relationship management system is on here. It's given us a vision of what is possible, of where our industry can go, how we can be more productive, how we can be more successful. This device is how we are going to run the future of the enterprise.
Developers and customers are taking it further into places we could never have imagined. And we're seeing uses out there that are just heartwarming and so exciting to see, because these are uses that change people's lives.
Assisting children with autism to communicate is a rather complicated process. The iPad is absolutely part of our clinical practice here. The screen size gives us enough real estate to be able to create materials and applications that are meaningful to them. You know, we're not curing autism, but we're offering a tool that improves the potential of a person with autism. It gives them more opportunities to be better communicators, to be better understanders, to be better learners. The iPad is clearly the next step. It's a game changer.
I define a miracle as something that comes in and changes your life for the better that you did not expect, you know, that you never thought could happen. When Leo was first diagnosed with autism, it really knocked me sideways emotionally, just to think that things would be difficult for my child. I mean, you never want anything to be difficult for your child. It's hard for Leo to be independent. It's hard for him to self-direct. But with the iPad, you know, it just makes him happy and independent. and he didn't have that ability before. This is something that my son can do, you know. He doesn't need me. You know, I don't want him to have to need me all the time.
We created a device that was going to be indispensable in the things we do every day. And not only do we achieve that, but it's going further, deeper, faster into our lives than we ever imagined. And this is just the beginning.